We will now learn how to join a class if you're a student, and if you're a teacher, how to communicate that. Now, you'll see this is my course here, the AP Econ Masters. Those are my economics guys again. And if I open that up, and I'll just click on that, you'll see there's three tabs up here. There's Stream, which we'll talk a lot about later. There's Students, and there's About. So let's look at Students. I have two students who are logged into this classroom, and I could invite a student, which would involve them having to say, yes, I want to join the class. So I'd simply click on Invite Student, and in this pane right here, I could begin to type in and search and come up with the student's name, check the box, and invite them. You could invite a whole bunch. You could even invite a whole group. So if I want to invite all the librarians, I could do that. However, that might not be the most practical way, because that's a lot of work on your side. So each course has a code, and you see this one right here. It says 4ENPFQC. Now this code would allow anyone, any student, to join the class. Now, how do they enter that? So I'm gonna go back to my main screen, and there's this little plus sign up here. Well, their classroom will look much like this, but without any windows in it. And they'll hit the plus button, and it'll say Join Class, and all they have to do is type in that code right there, and they're going to access that course right away. Now that's going to be a big help to you, so you don't have to go through and add each individually. However, sometimes if a student struggles and can't get in, again, the best thing you can do is open this up, go to Students, and just invite the student. You may also invite a student's guardian. So if a parent would like to kind of follow along and see what their student is doing and what you're posting, if you click on Invite Guardian, you simply have to type in the email and hit Invite. You can also add multiple guardians to that list. And so that's a great way to begin to engage parents and get them to think about what their students are doing, or their children are doing in your class as students. And so for the next video, we're going to look at how to make a course.